What is going on, everybody? It is your boy Crypto. Welcome back to another video, and in today's video we're going to be reacting to Machine Gun Kelly. Now I've been seeing him on YouTube over the last few days, and my man's just like dropping freestyles. It feels like every other day right now, and I guess the quarantine's just got him in his creative mode right now, and it's dope to see. I'm glad some artists are expressing themselves and they're, you know, putting the quarantine to good use. And a lot of people have asked me to react to the other things, and I've just been really busy, haven't been able to. I might go back and react to those if you guys want to, depending on how this video does, if he gets copyright claimed and all that other stuff. But he just dropped this new one. It's called In These Walls. Dropped it an hour ago, and I just happened to see it pop up on my YouTube page, going to record a different video. So I figured I'd give it a shot, see what's going on with Machine Gun Kelly, how he's using his time during the quarantine. And yeah, without further ado, guys, go ahead and pop a do. Let's get right on in to this review. Bam. Oh shit, that reminds me, I have a podcast now. It's called the Papa Do Podcast, of all things.
Welcome to the Papa Do Podcast.
Papa Do! It's with me and Joey Notto. We pretty much just get on there and talk about random things in the YouTube scene and the rap scene. We talked about basketball the other day. We just get on there and talk about anything, and it's a nice, fun listening experience during the quarantine. So please, go download to the description. It's going to be the first link. It's the Papa Do Podcast YouTube channel. Subscribe to that, please. We're trying to upload at least 2 podcasts a week. We're going to upload clips throughout the week. We're going to have a Spotify. Everything's going to be on streaming. It's all going to be there for you, but please, go subscribe to the Papa Do Podcast. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get on into Machine Gun Kelly. Bam. Oh shit, it's gonna be emotional. I wasn't expecting that. Damn. You always know it's gonna be real when a rapper is like rolling and lighting a blunt at the start of a sad music video. You can like see it in his eyes how sad he is right here. There's like a frost over him. That's okay. Well, I didn't know if it was gonna be like, I had no idea what the tone was gonna be, but it's obviously gonna be more emotional and sad. That Neumann mic though. It's like a $3,000 microphone. That's a beautiful setting, though. I'd love to be in quarantine there. That's a beautiful voice.
You said I never wrote a song for you, so I hope this one is haunting you. You said even if it took forever, that me and you would be together. And I never thought that you would lie, so I admit I took advantage of your precious time. I admit I took advantage of you every night that I was on the road. Even at home, I wouldn't do you right. I'll admit it, but don't think for a minute I'ma let you convince me that what we started is finished. Or for a second that I wouldn't take a bullet to the head for you. Paint the bottom of my floor red for you. Kissed by an angel, touched by the devil. Blood from a nose red as a rose petal.
Damn, okay, so he's reminiscing on a girlfriend that it's a relationship that he doesn't want to end, that she wanted to be done, and he's realizing all the stuff that, you know, it didn't really treat her the best. It's very reminiscent of, like, my song Footsteps, where I'm, like, reflecting and realizing all the stuff that I did incorrectly during a relationship and during, you know, a mutual friendship with someone. Damn, man. Fuck, I was not expecting sadness, but... you know, people need these types of songs in their life.
Paint the bottom of my floor red for you. Kissed by an angel, touched by the devil. Blood from a nose red as a rose petal. I think we're caught up in a power trip. She my Kate Moss, I'm her Johnny Depp. Life with a fast life.
Oh, she's my Kate Moss, I'm her Johnny Depp. That whole thing, that situation was fucked up, man. I don't know if you guys knew about that. I'm still very, I wouldn't say ignorant to the situation. I've read a couple headlines and a couple articles and stuff, but that whole situation was really fucked up, where she accused him of, like, being abusive to her, and then, like, an interview came out, or, like, a recording clip came out where she was abusive to him. It's just, like, a whole back-and-forth thing. Dude, just, oh, shit, okay.
Fast lane, bikes in the cab, nice drinking champagne. Ice making last ice for the back pain, with the knife on the dash pipe in the ashtray. And we fuck with the lights on, bring a lampshade. Did it twice in the room, once in the matinee. Hide all the fresh wounds like a band-aid, with the stripes on the black suit for the camp. Hey, what a damn shame. King of the underworld, what a damn name. Cause he killed all the other girls in a damn frame for a queen that he never realized had fangs. Damn, he still
killed all the other girls for a queen he never realized had fangs. That is a fucking dope ass line right there, man. Just like, he turned down all these other people, all these other relationships for someone that he thought was a queen, but the queen had fangs to sink her teeth in. Dude, That is a dope line, man. This is the Machine Gun Kelly that I really, really fucking enjoy. First of all, rap-wise, the schemes are really dope. The rhyme schemes, he has a lot of inner rhymes and, like, ending rhymes. And you don't even have to have those in an emotional song like this. So it's dope that he's doing that. And like I said, this is the Machine Gun Kelly that I thoroughly enjoy listening to. Queen that he never realized that things. Damn, do you feel what I'm saying? Take a knife in the back, wanna feel my pain. Make a slice in the wrist to reveal those veins. I can see your face, man, I feel insane. Man. Such a mess when I'm in your presence. I like that harmony right there. That's like his pop stuff coming, his punk rock harmonies coming out. Because I noticed he did like the Misery Business thing from Paramore. And like, I like it. Had enough. Gotta get you out of my system, yeah. It's my house. I think it's. Dude. Damn. Though that harmony right there, dude. There was like no autotune. There might have been like pitch correction and post and stuff, but like it was zero pitching that I could hear like autotune wise. He had some raspiness to him. Like I said, dude, this is some fucking dope ass Machine Gun Kelly right here. This is exactly what I love listening to from him. This is, even though like I hate that it's about this topic and that he's feeling underwhelmed or overwhelmed and like he's just sad. I mean, like I said, you can see the frost over his eyes, but it does make for good songs, which is a horrible, horrible catch 22 in the industry. You know, you got to use your sadness to create good music. It's just it's what it is in the industry. I understand it completely. Think it's time to get out. Man, that's some good harmony right there. All right. Shout out to MGK, man. Is my shirt on backwards? It is. I don't know why I put my shirt on backwards. Nice. Okay, whatever. Okay, so that was MGK in these walls. And like I said, man, I have seen him post like 6 or 7 songs, it feels like, in the last week and a half, 2 weeks. So my man's getting busy under some quarantine right now. But, dude, phenomenal, phenomenal fucking song. Machine Gun Kelly, if you're watching this, bro, very, very solid song. I love the harmony that you had right there. It was somewhat of a storytelling song, but like a reflective song. Very nice, man. Very, very nice. Much applauded effort on this song. Very nice. So I might go back and react to some of the other MGK stuff from earlier this week if you guys want. Please just let me know. But very nice song, and shout out to Machine Gun Kelly. But that will more than likely be the very end of this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, please drop a like. Subscribe if you guys want to. Probably going to have another video out today. Like I said earlier, I do have the Papa Dude podcast with Joey Notto and myself. Joey Notto is the guy that produces all my music. He produced my album. We did a collaboration album together. I don't know why I said collaboration like that. It was very drawn out and weird. We did a whole collab album together. Very nice guy. We literally just get on there and talk shit to each other. And just talk about random topics. So if you have anything you want us to talk about, let us know. But just go download to the description. First link in the description. Subscribe to that YouTube channel, the Papa Dude Podcast. And also it's going to be on Spotify and stuff. There's a link for Anchor, which is the place that we upload the streaming stuff to. But it should be on Spotify and all that other stuff eventually. They said it's going to be on there. But yeah, that will be the end of this video, guys. And until next time, it has been your boy, Crypt. Shout out to MGK. If you guys want me to react to some more MGK, let me know. And, yeah, that's the end of this video. Love you guys, and until next time, penis! Papa Doo!
Let's talk about the poppin' challenge.
Ah, the poppin' remix, man. That was fun times.
So, who do you think is going to win the poppin' challenge? Let's start off with that.
Who do I think is going to win, or who do I want to win?
You should be honest about that. I think it's going to be you, because I think it's going to be you that wins.
I think King Batch will win, just because he has millions and millions of followers. But I don't know. I don't know how the voting system works. He said he's taking the top three, and you can't see the voting outlook. Yeah. So I feel like KSI is going to do whatever he wants to do, really. I mean, he has every right to do whatever he wants to do. But I feel like you know, analytically, it would make sense for King Batch to win just because the amount of followers he has and what he brings to the table with the remix. Obviously, his verse was not good, per se.
I mean, I don't know.
It was not. It wasn't top 10 worthy.
No. I mean, it's not like crazy.
He had a cool video.
It's not like what you or Dizzy 8 or 6 Seconds or any of you guys did, but it matches the song.